Oh, hold your applause. It'll go to their heads. Well, good evening, everybody. And boy, howdy, I've waited 2 years to say this, but welcome. It is awesome. And before we get started, I just want to cover off a few things. We owe a debt of gratitude to the Gabriel DeMont Institute for this evening's show and just for assisting us in all kinds of things with this weekend in general. But Karen from GDI had approached John and I to do some shows, and I'm sure most of you have seen their postings. They're very active on the internet. They have a YouTube channel and their website. And throughout all of COVID, they were running these wonderful Métis artist concerts and lots of new ideas, lots of wonderful artists performing. And Karen and I were chatting, and we came up with this idea. John and I used to have, kitchen parties, jam sessions in our house, maybe once every month or two with a bunch of these young players. And I said to her, boy, wouldn't that be awesome if we could, you know, capture that and just call that a concert? Well, then we were talking about when to do it and how to do it and who would be involved. And the next thing you know, the government had slowly eased restrictions. And she said, well, why don't we just film it under the roof? Well, then we went with, why don't we just invite a bunch of people to the kitchen party? And then they opened everything up, and Fiddle Fest said, what the heck, we'll do a show tomorrow night too. So it was too late to pull off the whole Fiddle Fest, but we're sure happy that you're all here. And that's how the idea to have a Métis kitchen party was born. GDI did a fabulous job of making the stage look like an old Métis kitchen. A lot of work went into that too. Thank you, Tracy, for all of her help there. And I think it looks fabulous, and we're gonna try our best to emulate an old-time kitchen party. And you'll forgive the odd little piece of technology that has to stick out here and there, but we did try our very best. I would also be amiss if I didn't thank my admin assistant, Heather Vishloff, for all her help with everything, everything, period, but especially this weekend, and of course, just ongoing. My amazing board of directors who jump on the bandwagon instantly and are always there to help. Close your eyes, think back, think of the days. John's mom used to tell me a story about how they would all get together. They would travel long distances to get there. But there would be so many people in the house that they would actually take the wood stove out of the kitchen so that they could dance and have more room for more players. And, you know, just imagine that, if you will. Throw yourself back and enjoy a wonderful performance by some great musicians that I will introduce all to you after intermission. Enjoy the show.
Are we ready to party?
I figured I'd come in.
Are we all tuned up?
I think so. Double tap.
And what are we playing?
Well, what do you say we play the Constitution breakdown?
All right, here we go.
Raffled wagon polka.
Fantastic. I'm so happy to see everybody. So I was thinking, because I traveled, why don't we play the Traveler's Jig, John?
Okay.
Does that sound okay?
There, man.
All right. One, two, three, and...
Thank you.
everybody. My name's Tristen Durocher. So I'm wondering if we could all play Faded Love together.
We could. I'll try not to cry.
Okay. No crying, JJ. No crying.
It's the story of my life.
So this is Faded Love. Okay.
Kind of make me sad a little bit. Since we're in that kind of mood, I want to commemorate the Ward Island. So you want to play your original tune there, John?
Sure.
Let's get her going then.
Thank you.
That sounds just like Ward Allen, that tune.
What, huh?
That sounds just like Ward Allen.
Oh, you record, huh?
Good tune.
Yeah, and what else can we play? What's on the agenda?
Well, should we play a little bit of Smash the Window?
Okay, sure.
Okay.
Don't do Not it! Thinking about a tune I'd like to play. You know, there's lots of us guys here, but I don't see many girls. Oh, there's Cathy over there.
You fine piano player.
Mighty fine. You certainly are a poor girl with all these girls around here.
Well, that's not so bad.
Okay, well, maybe it's not so bad. Maybe, I was going to say the poor girl waltz we could play, but maybe we should change it to the happy girl waltz? No, we'll call it the poor girl. The poor girl waltz.
What's going on?
In the key of C. 1, 2, 3, 1, and... Thank you.
the old reel of eight? Did we do the old reel of eight?
All
okay.
Right.
This is an old Métis tune called The Old Reel of Eight. Yeah.
Yeah. Tristen, I think we should follow that with Rubber Dolly.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I like that tune a lot. That's a good pick.
Sounds good.
a tune.
Okay, let's play the Crooked Stone Pipe.
All right.
Waltz?
Oh, I like this one. Sounds just like cutting wood, just like the old yeah. Bucksaw.
Just like throwing the log.
Yeah, yeah. I bet you everybody will be able to hear the bucksaw in this too. Yeah. This your tune, John? This is your tune, isn't it, John?
Yeah.
Just like the old time logging days, eh? Thank you. That's the Bucksaw Waltz. The Bucksaw.
Saw?
Bucksaw. Just like the old Bucksaw.
Yeah. Just like found the wood.
Okay. I'm gonna pick a tune. I heard you guys were having a kitchen party here, so I wanted to. I see you got the tea out and everything. I was gonna bring some food too, and I was.
But Slim Pickens here, but he.
Somebody got to it before we got here. But I was gonna bring some snacks. I was making like potato chips in the oven. And they burnt on me, so it kind of reminded me of like the little burnt potato. So I thought, why don't we play the little burnt potato right now?
Okay.
Do you see that smooth segue?
Nice segue.
In the key of D? You got a good band for a kitchen party, eh?
I know how to pick up.
You do. 1, 2, and...
Fiddle song that people like to dance to. It's called the Seven Step. I don't know how to do it. I don't know how to dance to it, but I know how to play it. Do you know how to play it?
I know how to play it. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know how to play the Seven?
I've actually danced to it too.
Nice.
I don't know.
This is for all the Seven Steppers out there.
John just said I don't know.
You don't know the Seven Step? You know the Seven Step. We're good.
I usually when I'm counting it, I usually run out of fingers, but I'm lucky I have 2 feet, so I can go 5, 6, yeah. 7.
1, 2, 3.
I think it's about time we play Lucky Trapper's Reel, right?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds good.
Do you know the other name for this tune?
I do not.
Yeah, it's called the Unlucky Muskrat.
Okay. Hey, you guys ready?
Yeah.
We've actually given tea.
You had tea.
It's a miracle.
All right, well, I figure let's play one of the classics, St. Anne's Reel.
Oh, yeah, I like that too.
Great. Okay. One, two, one.
Thank you.
to get your foot above the table so Jordan can see.
What a great tune.
Oh, that's a good tune.
All right. Do a little bit of drops of brandy.
Drops of brandy?
Yeah, you're on it by yourself.
By myself? It's a lot of pressure, Johnny.
Because I know you. I know what your capabilities are.
You just had a birthday. You could actually have drops of brandy.
Yeah, I guess so.
Happy birthday, Jordan.
Thank you.
What about Bedford?
Yeah. Bedford Waltz, yeah.
Which one?
Bedford Waltz.
Bedford Waltz. Okay.
What gear did you start?
D?
Thank you.
a beautiful waltz.
Yeah.
I was thinking about a tune that we play often at jam sessions, something like Red Wing. That's a tune we play a lot. Yeah. Never heard of it? Is it hot in here? Is it?
Okay,
in the key of G, a little bit of Red Wing. 1, 2, and...
Well, we're going to play another Métis tune. Surprise, surprise. This one is called Jonah's First Change.
Jonah's First
Change. It's called Jonah's First Change. It's a jig. I really like this jig. It's on a Drops of Brandy CD that GDI had put out with two albums and two collections of music. And it was one of my very first fiddle CDs when I was young, other than John's Mia Shin album. Is that my saying that right? Mia Shin, I think that means it's good.
Good.
Yeah, it's good. That's what it means in Métis. So this is one of the first tunes I learned as a little fiddle player, maybe 10 or 11 or 12, around there. So there we go. There's my life story. Thanks for listening.
I always remember you taller than me.
Yeah.
You were little.
So I learned Jonah's First Change when I was 10, and it's been an uphill climb ever since. G.
time to slow it down. Sorry. Westphalia waltz, I think, right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
during COVID, I think most of you probably already know that John spends his winter, falls and winter, making fiddles. But he got real creative this winter and decided to try something really, really different and spent thousands of hours doing the carving or whatever. And for those of you on Facebook, you would have seen the big reveal, but he did what we're calling the buffalo bone fiddle. And he made all the accessories out of a buffalo bone. So he carved the fingerboard, the tuning pegs, the tailpiece, and the chin rest out of a big, long buffalo bone. My brother-in-law raises buffalo, so he went and dug in his bone pile and came up with a well-aged one. And it took a lot of work to get those made. It turned into an absolutely beautiful instrument, and we are really, really proud to say that it was purchased by the Gabriel Dumont Institute and will forever be housed in their museum in a beautiful display case so that everyone will get to see it. And I do encourage you to visit the new Gabriel Dumont Institute building on 22nd Street. Their museum is fantastic. It's a beautiful, beautiful new building, and they have a lot of amazing things there. And they were kind enough to reloan it to John for this evening's show, and I neglected to mention it. So. John is now working on fiddle number 74. Yeah, his goal is to make 100. So he says he wants to make 100 before he's 100. And if we have one more pandemic, he'll get there, trust me. Anyway, I think it's also time that we show some appreciation to these amazing musicians, and I felt like I would like to introduce each one of them. We're lucky enough this evening to have as piano accompaniment, Ms. Cathy Sproule. No stranger to the Fiddle Fest and part of our fiddle family for many, many years. A very talented lady. She also plays the guitar and several other instruments. And Mr. Metis himself here, Mr. Lucas Welsh, also a fine, fine fiddle player. Doing the guitar accompaniment for us tonight. As some of you may know too, John taught up in Isle of Cross for 10 and a half years, would have been 11 if the pandemic hadn't hit. He would travel up there once a month and spend a week in the school. The community and the school ran an amazing program there, and it was really, really something special. And John hung in there many, many years longer than he maybe thought he should. The drive was really hard to make, but he just didn't want to let it go. The people, the community, and the outcome was amazing. And hesitantly told him it was his final year, and then the pandemic hit, so it ended quickly. But really, really pleased to say that Lucas Welsh has stepped in and taken that position and will continue to teach in Isle of Cross. So the Métis fiddle will live on. Fiddles in the North program continues. So thank you, Lucas. Lucas and his family live in Meadow Lake, and he also teaches a lot of private students up there as well. So he's also a very talented musician and can do a lot more than play the fiddle and guitar. He can sing and whatever. The guy with the fancy fiddle and the fancy hat, well, you know, we'll get to him later. I'd like to bring everybody up in the same order they came up earlier. Put your hands together for Jordan Daniels. Jordan has been a student of John's for 10 years, and 10 years ago he told his kokum he'd like to have a fiddle. And she phoned me because someone told her John might have some old fiddles for sale. And she drove out here, and John sold her a $300 fiddle. And he said, you know, I could teach your grandson too. And as they say, the rest is history. And he's doing us all proud. He is now hired for many things, and it is great to see that the traditions and John passing it down, and it's going to live on. So good job, Jordan. Thank you. And next is Mr. Joseph Desjarlais. Now, hands together for him. John, get in your chair. Joseph is one of the things that came out of Fiddles in the North in Isle of Cross. The way they start that program, you take fiddle from Mr. Arcand if you're in grade 5, and Joseph did that and has carried on. Joseph is going to university full-time and plays the fiddle at many gigs, and once again, doing a good job of keeping the traditions alive. So, good job. Now, this next guy, you know, guy, right? Well, we might say there's lots of people up here. Yes, oh, I love you too. All taught by John, which all the young fellows have been. JJ, not really, but JJ kind of just grew up with John, didn't you? Yeah, JJ has been playing the fiddle since he was 7 years old. Comes from around the Tufnell Foam Lake area, was always at contests, etc. Him and John have jammed and taught each other lots of things many times over the years. I am beyond delighted to share with you tonight, if you haven't known it or seen it already, that JJ Guy is the first Saskatchewan fiddle player to ever be inducted into the North American Fiddle Hall of Fame, and that happened last week. Really, really, really doing Saskatchewan proud, and he's an amazing guy. He's, again, been a part of the Fiddle Fest family forever. Wonderful teacher, travels all over, has a great act with Gord Stobie, Twin Fiddles, teaches lots of workshops. Everybody loves JJ. JJ just, yeah.
I love everybody.
Everybody loves JJ. And next, put your hands together for Mr. Tristen Durocher. Tristen is another young fellow that, you know, we can't really honestly say he took lessons from John. He wasn't a student. He wasn't in a school where John taught. But he made it a point, or his family made it a point, for him to search out John, find John, come and learn from John, buy one of John's fiddles, and become a part of the Fiddle Fest family and everything else. And a very talented young man with a bright future ahead of him there, too. So, Mr. Tristen Durocher. And last, but definitely not least, Mr. Jeremy Corrigal. Jeremy is also a product of Fiddles in the North in Isle of Cross. And he, as well as Joseph, started taking fiddle in grade 5 from Mr. Arcand and just kept it going. Joseph went on to university this year. Jeremy actually helped out with the fiddle program and assisted Lucas and worked with the kids when Lucas wasn't there. So well done, Jeremy, and keep up the good work. You also are keeping the traditions alive. I thank you all for coming. It feels so good to have you back in here again. It's been a wonderful evening. I just thank you all you players. You've just been amazing. Thanks again to GDI for bringing us together. We'll be right back.
Why don't we play one of my favorite tunes to play is Joys of Quebec. It's always a happy.
Oh, I don't think so.
No Joys of Quebec?
No.
Oh, that's okay.
Unfortunately.
How about Chinese Breakdown?
Yep.
That's a good one.
Yeah, that's a good tune.
In the key of D.
1, 2, 3.
you like to play?
I'd just like to say I'm glad we took an intermission because my G string was getting kind of tight there, eh?
You loosened it?
I loosened it backstage there. So, let's play something on the G string. I say Big John McNeil.
All right.
The big game. Where's my other student here? Eva, where are you sitting?
Which corner?
Oh, you better come and dance.
Good?
Ready?
Yeah. Teardrop?
Atlantic.
Oh, the Atlantic. First change of the Atlantic polka also works for a good heel and toe.
All right. Yeah, call out the same dance. Is it my turn? Already?
No, do it.
Do you want to do teardrop?
Yeah.
Sure.
Oh, peekaboo.
Hey, there you go.
We were talking about this once.
That one snuck up on us.
We'll play the peekaboo and then we'll get the teardrop. We'll make sure we get the teardrop waltz in because that's what we're
going to do. Okay.
The peekaboo first. One, two, three, one, and... So lots of people were asking for a teardrop waltz. I think we should play it. It's everybody's favorite.
Yep. Yay.
Yay.
Okay, go ahead.
Reg Bobet.
Isn't that Andy Desjarlais?
No, Reg.
No? Okay.
One, two, three, one, and... Thank you. Let's do Walking Uptown. Do people know Walking Uptown?
No, I don't think so. I
never heard that before.
Liberty Two-Step is a good one.
Somebody said Sherbrooke Reel.
Sherbrooke Reel?
Yeah. You guys know Sherbrooke Reel?
Let's do the Liberty Two-Step in the key of D.
Okay.
Key of D. One, two, in.
Good jig. Okay.
Murray River jig.
Singer. Oh, Murray River jig.
Murray River jig.
All right.
All right. We're going to get jiggy with it. Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Go ahead.
1, 2, and... We'll be right back.
want to pick one, Lucas? Do you have a favorite we didn't do?
Girl I Left Behind Me.
Okay.
Is that... That's Andrea, right?
Yeah.
That's
yeah. Do it the kids at home. Don't tell her I said that.
All right, a little bit of Girl I Left Behind Me.
Key of G. All right.
One, two, and... Manitoba Golden Boy, that's a good Andy DeJarvis tune.
Yep.
Go ahead, sir.
He's the symbol of success.
He's the gateway to the West.
He's our legendary pride and joy. The Manitoba Golden Boy, we're singing lyrics of it, but we'll play it, eh? Key of D. One, two, and...
So that's that golden statue above the legislative building in Manitoba. That's the Manitoba Golden Boy. I learned that last summer. Yeah. What else we got?
Memories of Emma Lake.
Oh yeah, yeah. Sure.
That one?
Let's do that one.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Memories of Emma Lake.
Memories
of
Emma Lake.
Yeah.
All right.
Ready.
Slippers, we could do golden slippers or
yeah.
Golden slippers in the key of G. Key of G, golden slippers. 1, 2, and. Oh, round two.
Indeed.
Yeah. Okay.
What about loggers
wall? Log drivers walls? Yeah.
What about black velvet walls?
Black velvet.
There you go.
There you go.
Nikia C. We're gonna play the Black Velvet Waltz. 1, 2, 3, 1, and.
Some nice guitar and piano chords there.
I was kind of thinking, because since we ended kind of early on Maple Sugar, we should play it again.
Oh, yes.
Good.
No?
Oh, yeah.
Is that a bad idea or is that a good idea? We did kind of get cut off halfway through.
Probably a bad idea.
Yeah?
Are we talking about
again? Jimmy's favorite jig. You know
that's a good one, yeah?
Jimmy's favorite jig? Yeah.
Oh, I like that one.
Yeah, play it.
Okay.
Yeah,
play
Cathy
wants some jigs.
I made you.
Thank you.
right, we're Okay, I'm on. Okay, guys, we're going to do like one more tune. And then how does everybody feel about doing the Red River Jig? We're all good? Does everybody, does every one of you want to cross tune for the Red River Jig? Okay.
Are we doing all now? One more before.
We do one more. And then for those of you that don't know, to traditionally play the Red River Jig, you have to cross tune your fiddle. So it takes them a minute, and we like to end every performance we can, especially a Métis kitchen party, with the Red River Jig, and we invite you to all get up and jig.
How about tune me again?
Get jiggy with it, as they say. So pick a tune for one more tune, and then we'll take a little break to cross tune, play the Red River Jig, and we'll call it an evening.
All right. Feel great.
Smile the while. Smile the while. Indeed.
All right.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, in. We'll be right back.
job, good job. Thank you.
Okay, there we go. Now I'm gonna.